Good morning, conference. We feel very privileged to be able to speak to at Reforms UK's very first conference. Everyone here should be proud to be part of the fight of our freedom and our future. My name is Councillor Alan Graves from Derby.
And my name is Councillor Alan Graves Jr. from Derby.
I am so proud that my son and I are Reform councillors together, giving the opposition mainstream parties a run for their money.
And we are also very proud of our achievements in Derby.
Now, I've been a councillor since 1995, starting as a Labour councillor under Tony Blair's influence. That wasn't the reaction I was expecting.
Yeah. I was booing as well.
In 2014, I was re-elected as a UKIP councillor in the same ward.
In 2018, after deciding I'd had enough of the mainstream parties making decisions that only benefited them and their friends, I decided to stand as a councillor. And in my very first attempt, I won. Thank God you cheered. And this is because I stole my father's blueprint, and today you can steal it too.
Now this year we added yet another councillor in Derby and increased our tally to 6 Reform councillors.
It's important to note that Derby is not a natural Reform hotspot for any other reason than our hard work. So it is simple, but it is not easy. It does require hard work, but thankfully, it does not require a PhD in brain surgery.
Well, our time today is limited, so I'll give you a brief version of what we do. Knock on every voter's door at least once. This sounds very daunting at first, but once you have done it a few times, it gets very easy. There are two main aims when you're knocking on the door: letting people know who you are, and more importantly, finding out who they vote for. This is actually easier than you think, believe me. Target the voters using the information you gained during the door knocking. Leaflets are very useful to get the message out, but targeting letters is very important. If the election comes down to just 50 votes, these letters can sway it in your favour. Make sure you fill every council seat with a candidate. Once you start door knocking, you will be surprised at how many willing volunteers you get. Do something for the election every single day, starting today. The only better time to start was yesterday. And as everybody knows, tomorrow never comes. I always plan my strategies in June, ready for the following May. So elections are not won in May. They are won 10 months before, when you are knocking on the doors of voters, finding out what is important to them.
Now, obviously, this is a very, very condensed version. But if you are serious about winning elections, Alan Senior is here all day, and I can assure you he will gladly chew your ear off and give you all the trade secrets about winning elections.
Right, we're not here to gloat about how amazing the process is that we use. We're here to tell you that no matter where you are from, with the right strategy, with the right determination, we, as a party, will win elections.
And we are also here to tell you that without winning elections, our voice, your voice, means nothing. In Derby, we are the thorn in the side of the mainstream parties, and we love it.
And equally importantly, they hate it. We have overturned many horrendous decisions in the council that would have wasted millions of pounds of taxpayer money.
I think you're all here because you have strong political beliefs that do not match those of the mainstream parties. Is that right?
Yes.
Well, left to them, we would never have achieved Brexit. Mm. Although I would advocate that we are now all in it together, so there should be no differences between ex-leavers and ex-remainers.
Yeah.
We should only be concerned about those that are a minority of rejoiners. I learned to campaign with the Labour Party. I updated my approach to the elections by looking at other parties, and I added my own spin on how to present the party to the public to achieve a successful win. But make no mistake, though I am still learning, and we should all be open to better ways of getting there. Let me tell you this. Think about the Liberal Democrats and the Green Party.
I can see some looks out there that exactly the same as what when he first said this to me, that's how I looked as well. But there is a point to it, I promise.
These parties are also small, yet they have MPs. Why is that, you might wonder? Well, if you look at where they exist, you will find below them a raft of councillors from the same party. We are here to tell you that local elections are as important, if not more important, to achieve success in parliamentary elections. I believe that every single one of you has a responsibility to consider your part in that process.
Without successfully elected people, there is no voice. And if reform is to win elections, we need to start at the grassroots and build our foundation in the long term so that we can be heard on a national level.
So here in Derby, we have built, well, we're in Manchester, aren't we? But in Derby, we have built a team over a number of years. We plan, we strategize, and we execute. The result so far, as I've told you, is 6 councillors out of 51. We have a long way to go, but we are already setting ourselves up to fight the next general election. Now, I know that Richard has some exciting announcements later, and I'm expecting those people to lead the march in their respective areas. I'm also expecting many of you to be leading the march in your areas. It reminds me of the saying, do not ask what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Well, I'm asking you, what can you do for your party? We're all as important as each other in our battles. So what would you contribute towards our freedom and our future?
Trust me when I say, if I can do it, anybody can do it. If we act as a team, fight as a team, and win as a team, we will gain our freedom, our future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Alan.